Feeding forage is a good way to complement your rabbit's diet and provide enrichment, plus it's free. Sometimes it can be tough to identify plants from photos, so in this video I'm going to show you 5 common wild plants you can collect for your rabbit. Remember, any new food should be introduced gradually. This is a dandelion. They're very common and grow in all sorts of places. You might even have them in your garden. Each stem has a single bright yellow flower on the end, and when the flowers die, they're replaced with a pom-pom shaped seed head. The bright green leaves in the flower stems all radiate out from a central point. Rabbits can eat the leaves, stems and flowers, and you can dry the leaves for eating later. These are stinging nettles. Even if you don't feed them to your rabbit, it's handy to be able to identify them as they cause a stinging rash if you accidentally brush against them. That doesn't deter rabbits though. They seem immune to the stings and consider these a tasty snack. They usually grow in a big clump around 2 or 3 foot tall. They have pointed leaves serrated along the edges and the tassels near the top are the flowers. You'll need gloves and long sleeves to pick them, but they also dry well for winter. Blackberries, or brambles as they're sometimes called, are one of the best plants for rabbits. They have tasty fibrous leaves that are great for those with sensitive tummies. They can often be found in hedgerows and under trees. They have thick leaves and long arching stems with lots of spikes. These are quite bright green and shiny as their new growth. The leaves and stems get darker and duller as they age. This is the older growth. From May they'll have white or pale pink flowers, and as the petals fall away, small green berries appear that grow and turn into blackberries. Rabbits can eat the stems and the leaves, they'll even manage those prickles, and the leaves dry really well for winter. This is plantain. It often grows among grass, so the long flower heads can make it easier to spot. They're a long stem with a little tuft on the end. Plantain is sometimes called ribwort because the thick leaves have long rib-like veins running down the length of them. If you tear a leaf, you'll find they're stringy, a bit like celery. This is narrow-leaf plantain, and this is broad-leaf plantain. The leaves are very similar, except short and fat instead of long and thin. Both can be fed fresh or dried for later. Lastly, this is Herb Robert, and it's part of the geranium family. It's a little less common, at least where I live, but the bright pink, 5-petal flowers are easy to spot. The leaves remind me a little bit of parsley in shape, with lots of splits, and they sometimes have a red tinge to the edge. Like the other plants, you can feed it fresh or dry. So that's 5 plants you can feed to your rabbit. See if you can spot them near where you live. When you're picking plants, remember, only pick from places free from pollution and dog fouling. Only pick from places you've permission or public land that allows foragers. Only take a small portion of what you find and don't damage the plant's roots. Make sure you've identified plants correctly.